a special device is, which can accelerate a charged particles up to the speed of light, and a special detectors, which were able to visualize a tracks of particles gave rise for hunting to new elementary particles. In the middle of 20th century, a lot of subatomic particles similar to proton and neutron were discovered. It seems that by analogy with the periodic table, some fundamental building blocks should exist. Different theoretical models were built, but it was necessary to look into some of these particles. Such experiment was performed by SLAC-MIT collaboration. The idea of this experiment was very similar to the gold foil experiment. Let's see what were changed. Let's begin with a target, or an object of investigations. In gold foil experiment, it was a gold foil. In SLAC-MIT experiment, it was changed to the cylinder, 7 centimeters, with liquid hydrogen. Hydrogen is consist of one proton and one electron far beyond from proton, so we have a lot of protons. As hydrogen is liquid, under very low temperature, all protons are very close to each other. Next is the source. In the gold foil experiment, the source of alpha particles was very small piece of radium. SLAC-MIT group used the special device, which is called accelerator. It work in the following way. Let's take a glass tube and two electrodes, red and blue. Blue electrode will attach to the negative pole, minus of battery, and red electrode will attach to the positive pole, plus of battery. If we put inside the tube the source of electrons but switch off battery, the electrons will go in anyway. If we switch on battery, then the electrons will be accelerated along the electrical field. To accelerate the electrons up to speed of light, we should take a lot of such tubes with electrodes. So, we obtain the linear particle accelerator, which is almost 3 kilometers in long. The energy of the electrons is 40,000 times more than the energy of alpha particles used in the experiments of Rutherford. In Rutherford's experiments, the scintillator plates only indicate that alpha particle passed off them. However, the position of the flash of light can be used for the determination of coordinate in which a particle crossed the scintillator plate. The most effectively to do this by dividing the scintillator plate into several segments or narrow strips and attach to each strip a photoelement, which will register a flash. Then, the coordinate of a passing particle is equal to the coordinate of a flashing strip up to a width of this strip. The more narrow strip will give the more accurate result. Such device, which consists of the array of organic scintillators, is called hodoscope, from the Greek hodos for way or path, and scopos an observer. Thus, with the help of hodoscope, we can measure the scattering angle of the particle, if you place hodoscope vertically. Moreover, we can measure in a similar way the momentum, or velocity, of a charged particles. A charged particle in a magnetic field will move on a circle. Knowing the radius of the circle as well as the charge and mass of this particle, we can find its momentum, or velocity. If we take an uniform magnetic field, all particles will move along a circle. But if we take special magnets, we can change the trajectory of particles according well-known law. To determine the radius of this curve, we need to measure the particle trajectory in a horizontal plane. For this purpose, the second hodoscope was used, which was disposed at some angle to the direction of electrons. Measuring the coordinate of a particle with the help of hodoscope, we can easily calculate the momentum, or velocity, of this particle. Now we are ready to construct SLAC-MIT detector. It is placed on some angle under the direction of motion of electrons. One of hodoscope will measure this angle. The system of magnets will change the trajectory of electrons to find their momentum, or velocity, with the help of second hodoscope. After two hodoscopes, the calorimeter was installed, which absorbs each electron and measures the absorbed energy. This is a photo of detector, which was used in SLAC-MIT experiment. You can see people near this detector to imagine its real size, which is about 10 to 30 meters. Its weight is about 750 tons. We can compare SLAC-MIT detector with laboratory of Rutherford. The difference is much impressive. However, SLAC-MIT detector can measure scattering angle, momentum and energy. The idea of SLAC-MIT experiment was similar to the gold foil experiment. Study a distribution of an electrical charge inside the proton. Because the energy of the electrons from the linear accelerator is much more than the energy of alpha particles from radium in the gold foil experiment, then these electrons can look inside the proton like alpha particles look inside the atom. In the gold foil experiment, the number of alpha particles in some scattering angle were detected. The SLAC-MIT experiment can measure the scattering angle, momentum and energy of the scattering particle. This gives much more information, which can be used for the analyze of the scattering process. It is not hard to compute the general formulae for the numbers of particles, which will scattering to some angle and have some energy. If proton don't have any internal structure, then the SLAC-MIT collaboration should obtain a data close to the following graphic, which predict the low number of events with the higher values of transferring energy from electron to proton. But they found instead many events. There seemed to be something small and hard inside the proton. Thus, it was found that the proton has an internal structure. It consists of smaller components.